morning, all students. Today, I want to discuss about living things and non-living things, along with their characters and some examples. Today, I'm going to teach topic. This topic is especially related for students belonging to class 4, 5, and 6. And so, let's now try to discuss about this topic. Firstly, before understanding about living things and living things, living things and non-living things. Before starting this topic, firstly try to understand about what are things. Listen. Things means all domain, all that present in our earth or universe, which have fixed mass and occupy space. These occupying space and having fixed mass are called things. And these things that we can observe at every place on our earth, in our universe. And these things are classified into different groups depending on different mode of classification, different method of classification. And generally, classification is things are divided into living things and non-living things. As you all know, living things are those things which have life and have sense organ. Life means that can eat, that can breathe, that can move, that can feel. And non-living things just occur to that living things. Non-living things are all those things which do not have life and sense organ. Which do not have life means that cannot eat, that cannot breathe, that cannot move, that cannot so feel. And also after this, we also further try to understand about other parts, other groups of these living things. Living things are also as things classified into two groups. Living things are also classified into different groups. And here also, classification of these living things are also of different type. And depending on here, I am going to classify living things depending on presence or absence of backbone. So, let's try to understand about further parts of living things. Depending on presence or absence of backbone, these living things are classified into two groups. One is vertebrates, and other part of living things are invertebrates. Vertebrates means those living things which have vertebral column or backbone. Vertebral column means that main bone which is present on our back, on backside of animals. And that main bone, also called vertebral column, gives rise to further bone, also called subbone. And similarly, just opposite to these invertebrates are those living things which do not have vertebral column or which do not have main backbone. And now further try to also understand about different parts, different groups of vertebrates. Because living things are divided into two groups, vertebrates are also called plus. Further also different groups. And here also elevated and generally body covered with a scale. And after this species, next one comes as amphibians, also called amphibia. Amphibia means plural form of amphibian. Similarly, after this, next one is reptilia. Next one, apes. And last one, also called advanced animals among all animals from animals belonging to vertebrates, that is mammalia. And also further try to separately discuss about these five groups. And let's now discuss about firstly about these species. In detail about this first one group species. Listen, these species are also called fishes. As all fishes, generally all fishes belong to this group fishes. And main feature of these animals belonging to fishes are they are aquatic animals. They are cold-blooded animals means those animals whose body temperature changes with the changing temperature of our surrounding. And further also, their body is covered with a smooth scale which help in swimming, and also that scale prevents entering water inside body of these animals. First one is, they are